hello again. Today we're going to cook something for Chinese New Year. Chinese New Year is a few weeks from now, and the thing that I'm going to make, or the soup that I'm going to make, is called Kiam Chye Ark. Kiam Chye Ark is a very traditional dish that we have. It's a soup, actually, we have for Chinese New Year. And I remember eating this since, well, I was very young. And we've still been eating this particular dish. So it's handed down from my grandparents, my mom, and now to me. And then I'm passing it to my children. So this dish has got salted mustard leaves, and we cook it with duck. Actually, we boil it for a long time, for about an hour. And so this is a very, very traditional one. And this is my family recipe. Other families have their own recipe. It's somewhat like fish and chips, you know, everybody does their own, but we have our own. So here, I'm going to show you my traditional dish for Chinese New Year, and we usually cook this dish for festivities. So hi, I'm Loretta Lee, Nyonya Recipe. Nyonya Recipe is a fine place for fabulous food. And if you like the video that I show, or if you like the video that you see, please don't forget to click like and hit the subscribe button so that you can be informed of all the videos that I upload every day. So let's go and see how to make Kiam Chye Ark soup. To make the Kiam Chye Ark, this is what we need. We need about 300 grams of Kiam Chye, or Chinese pig. Pickled mustard green. This is about 350, so it's okay. It's all right. You also need duck. You can use half a duck or one duck if it's a big recipe. I'm only going to use 2 to 3 duck legs. My original recipe calls for 4, but I've only got 2, and I'm going to make half a recipe. One onion. We have Chinese plum, yeah? I'm going to take out about 2 Chinese plums. Preserved Chinese plum. Yeah, it's like this. You may need more than 3, but we will taste the soup later on to see whether we have enough. Okay. 1 tomato. If it's a full recipe, you use a big tomato. This is quite a small one. So those are the vegetables and the required main ingredients. And now to put in a spice bag, 1 knot of ginger, about 30 grams, and sliced. You need 5 cloves of garlic, 1 teaspoon white peppercorn, a nutmeg kernel. You take out the hard skin. Yeah, you take out the hard skin, you only want the kernel. So we're going to crush the nutmeg. Okay, and then I'm going to put it in the bag. I'm going to lightly crush the peppercorns, yeah. Lightly crush the peppercorns, and then the garlic also lightly mash. Okay, and together with the slices of ginger, you put all in the bag, and then we tie it up. This is the bag which we want to put in the soup. And now for the you have to cut the mustard green. This one comes with a piece of chili. This one you can wash it, and then you cut it and soak it with water. So we trim off all the hard pieces, yeah. And then we cut it into bite size. Not too small. It's soup, then it's cooked for quite a while, so it needs to be a bit, quite a big piece, but not too big. So we soak it with some warm water for about half an hour, so that it won't be so salty and sourish. If you try it now, it's quite sourish. Oh, very sour. So we soak it for about half an hour, and we test. So we're going to cut the rest of the vegetables. So we just cut it into wedges, cut into four. Tomato, you can cut into four or eight, up to you. Okay. And then the duck, we're gonna cut it into about four pieces. Some people don't cut it, it's okay. Some people leave it whole, it's still okay. And we like to eat it with the bone on, because when you cook, I think three is enough. Three is a good piece. We've cut it. So I'm going to put this in and we're going to cook the soup now. So now we're going to put all everything together. So we'll put the spice back. The vegetables. Not necessarily in the order that I'm telling you. Okay. And the duck. The onions and the tomato. I think I put a tomato later on. Put a tomato later on. And then whatever that came in with the mustard green, I'm going to add it in the chili. And you can put extra chili if you want. Okay. And then you take the plums. You squash about two of it with your finger. Just two of it. They sit inside, so be careful. If you want, you can remove the seed, but normally I don't. Then we add some hot water, about 1 to 1.5 liters. I use hot water, it's faster. Then you put it on the stove and you let it bring it to the boil. So now it's boiling. Ooh, we're gonna give it a stir. Lower the flame. Simmer, and we simmer for about 40 minutes or so, and stirring it occasionally. So now it's about 45 minutes in here. Of course, I stir it a few times so that it doesn't stick. So let's try the taste. You see, because the duck has got quite fatty, so it's got a layer of like oil on top. So let's try the taste and see. The duck should be cooked and tender, but you can still do it a few more minutes if you want. Let's try. It's good. So I think it's not sour enough, so I'm going to put one more of this plum. So I'm going to squeeze it and put everything inside. And it also needs some salt. It would naturally have a salty and sourish taste, but I just want to make sure that it's well adjusted. Okay. And then I'll add some salt. I think I have about 1/2 teaspoon. I'm going to add in the tomato. So if you put it on a simmer, your duck meat won't sort of become mesh up, so it's still in pieces. But you have to leave it long enough for it to be tender. So let me try again. I've also put in, remember, I also put in one more plum, preserved plum. Okay, I'm gonna try it. Good. So this will be ready. So here we are. After 15 minutes, the soup is ready. And then before you serve, you can remove the bag. Okay, it's ready. So here it is. Okay, let's switch it off. This is our preserved duck and salted vegetable soup. Hi, I hope you enjoy watching me making the kiam chye ark. And I was so engrossed and I ate it and I forgot to show you how it tastes. So apologies for that, but it tastes extremely lovely and I'm going to make it again for Chinese New Year. Actually on the eve of Chinese New Year, that's where we have our reunion dinner and that's where all Chinese will come together from all over the places. If the children are, you know, spread all over the, you know, the country, they'll all come back to the parents' house for a reunion dinner. And that's why you see every year there'll be flocks and flocks of people in China or Malaysia or Singapore who will go home to their parents or their eldest family, the eldest person in the family, to have a reunion dinner. That's what the reunion dinner is all about, and we have this for our reunion dinner. So unfortunately I didn't show you how tasty it is, but I absolutely love it. It's so tangy and sour and a bit salty, and that's what I like about it. So until the next time, don't forget to click like and hit the subscribe button so that you can be informed of all the recipes that I upload. And if you think you have friends or family who would like to know more about Chinese New Year recipes, please send them this way. Till then, bye, see you. Thank you.